What's happening, folks, and welcome to another episode of Stars of Tomorrow. If you can, in case you're new to this series, this is a series where we look at some of the young players on FM20 and we see how they develop over the course of their careers, both players that I pick, from players I'm curious about, and also players that you guys suggest in the comment section. So down below, guys, while I'm on that subject, leave a comment down below about a player you would like to see me review. But also, they also say leave as much info on that player as possible, and also check the playlist and make sure your player has not been done already. Today's player is João Félix. And also, don't forget to like and comment the video and help the algorithm find our videos and that kind of thing. You know, got to play the game, like I always say. Today's player is João Félix. Next player I'm going to do, guys, just FYI, is Vinicius Jr. A subscriber has asked for that player, so that's the next player on the list. So if you make a suggestion for a player, it'll be the third episode after this one instead of the balance by the end of the series. So João Félix signed for Let's Go Madrid for £112 million, linked with every single big club in the world, it felt like. Even United were linked with him, but I never thought it was gonna happen. He's a attacking midfielder who can play left wing. How is he natural in positions? Natural in those areas. Strong on his left foot, very strong on his right foot. So, you know, could say he's two-footed, arguably. Likes around the goalkeeper, plays 1-2, tries first-time shots, and cuts inside from the left wing. Now, for me personally, I'd play him more centrally because of the lack of pace. But then again, that's personal preference. I'm sure, you know, you don't need pace to be a good winger, but ideally. But again, good finishing, good composure, good dribbling. You know, the wide area wouldn't be the worst place to play in, would it? So, let's go forward, guys, and see how he gets on at Let's Go Madrid in his early years. And or if he leaves for a big club very quick, a massive club quickly, where he goes. Right, folks, he's still at Let's Go Madrid. And you can see the mental stats have gone up. Rest of it is pretty much the same. Player traits are the same as well. Injury records, let's have a look here. Pretty injury free for in my view. Also, I've got to mention, I knew I'd forgotten something. There is no webcam in these videos because I don't think we need one for this kind of series. For a let's play on with Wolves and the FIFA stuff, I think webcam is kind of, you know, makes sense for those videos. And also, there's no July 4 on the webcam because it's a narrative game and there's talking and cutscenes, so just easy to do that. So that's why there's no webcam, in case you're wondering. I've not made an error, there's no webcam. Composure to 17, so let's look how he's got on in the years that was good. So 19 goals, 3 assists in his first season, 19-9, then 15-8, and 16-8. Where can we see where he's playing this season? He's playing a striker this season. Yeah. I think he can play a striker. I don't have a problem with that. I mean, ideally, the pace is an issue. For me, I like a bit fast, more pace for my strikers, ideally, if they're at this age. But yeah, doing pretty well. Let's Go Madrid. 137 appearances, 43 goals. So yeah, let's continue and see how he gets on further down the line. He is still at Atletico Madrid, folks, which is interesting. Again, I think we've still got the same player traits, and again, more or less the same physical stats and technical and mental stats, which is interesting to see. Injury record, few more here, but nothing that would alarm me massively about that. And career stats, have a look. So we got to about here, didn't we? So we'll keep going. 16-8, 13 goals, 12 assists, 22 goals, 9 assists, 23 goals, 4 assists, and 16-8. Where are they playing this season? They're playing as strikers. They're playing as a striker. You know what? Yeah, I mean, again, I don't see issue with that. He's obviously scoring goals. 96 goals in a 269 appearances for Let's Go Madrid. I still think you could get a lot of him in the wide areas and maybe in cameras or as a shadow striker. Either foot, has he got a very strong weak foot now? No, but either foot as well. So, again, the contract information is he's got a massive release clause in his contract. So, bear that in mind. It's going to cost a lot of money to get him out of Let's Go Madrid. Hopefully, he moves on somewhere so we can gauge that. Let's have a look. So, folks, as you can see here, he's now 32 years old, and the stats are the same, relatively stay the same. But look at the mental stats. vision and off the ball, flair and composure are on the really, really high. Injury record. He hasn't moved clubs, though, so we can't gauge his transfer fee, but he's probably talking about 100 million, most likely. No major injury. One major injury in the whole of this check on him. So, where do we get to here? 13-6, 22-6, 14-2, 17-4, 16-10. Where did he play this season? Okay, main striker again. So, is it they seem as a striker. Strong on both feet. Good finishing. Great composure. Can play wide as well if you want him to. Definitely a player that if you're doing an ethical good save, you're going to enjoy. I would say you're going to have a nightmare getting him out of there. But then again, every save's different. You never know how saves. If for some reason Madrid have a really poor start to the season, or he's still there and the mid-table and you work on it, you never know. Weird things can happen on FM. But yeah, really good player. I just think it's really hard to get him out of the club he's at. But yeah, quality player. At least if you're managing Atletico Madrid, you've got a quality player. So until next time, guys, thank you so much for watching. As I said, next episode is going to be a subscriber suggested player in the form of Vinicius Jr. I'll see you for that episode. Don't forget down below if you enjoyed it, leave a like on the video to help support the channel and the series, and subscribe to see more from the channel as well. And I'll see you all next time. Bye bye.